Welcome to Declassifying the Paranormal. Here we reveal the secrets that sinister organizations attempt to conceal from the world, objects and entities that could shake the very foundations of what we think is, and is not, possible. Today we have secured documents belonging to the SCP Foundation, and will reveal to you the nature of SCP-2416.
Item number, SCP-2416. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. The current instance of SCP-2416, now SCP-2416-21, is to be kept in a drug-induced coma at Site 59 and monitored for vital signs. If SCP-2416-21 dies for any reason, Mobile Task Force Omicron 8 sent in the clowns is to be placed on high alert, and the replacement instance is to be apprehended and contained in the same manner as soon as possible. Description: SCP-2416 refers to multiple instances of a 35-year-old Caucasian human male named Joseph Grunderson Pike. Despite having unextraordinary brain activity and no history of neurological disorders, SCP-2416 displays diminished intellectual capacity and a high likelihood of getting into a lethal accident. On January 14, 2006, SCP-2416-1, the original instance, insofar as the Foundation is aware, the likelihood of previous instances has not been ruled out, was killed after walking onto an expressway in Chicago. This was not believed to have been suicide. Shortly before it was struck by a speeding minivan, its last words were reportedly, "Hey, this isn't State Street." SCP-2416-1 had funeral services, was cremated, and its death was reported in multiple Chicago newspapers. On March 15, 2006, a living instance of SCP-2416, SCP-2416-2, was stabbed to death in Omaha after it tied a convicted murderer's shoelaces together for a prank. SCP-2416-2 was determined by law enforcement officials to be an outsider with no friends or relations in Omaha and was buried. It is unknown how a new instance of SCP-2416 appears after the death of a previous instance. The latest instance always claims to have no recollection of having died at all, and has passed multiple polygraph tests while giving this testimony. The origin point of a reincarnated instance has never been successfully located, and all sightings of SCP-2416 instances have been after the fact.
Instance cause of death comments.
SCP-2416-3 overconsumption of pepper sauce. Witnesses report that SCP-2416-3 was attempting to become the spiciest. SCP-2416-4 head split in half with a table saw.
Last words were reportedly, "Gimme a kiss."
SCP-2416-5 mauled by a puma.
Had covered self in uncooked bacon in a zoo puma habitat on a dare.
SCP-2416-6 rattlesnake bite.
Last words were reportedly, "Gimme a kiss."
SCP-2416-7 slept in the center of a freeway.
Was tired.
SCP-2416-8, redacted, the badger suffered only minor injuries. SCP-2416-9 shot by Chilean anarchists.
Last words were reportedly, "Gimme a kiss."
SCP-2416-10 subjected to voluntary human experimentation by Church of the Broken God scientists. Ultimate cause of death was cranial hemorrhage.
Corpse was discovered by the Foundation in a raid on the COT-BG compound. Dr. A. reported corpse's resemblance to an urban legend about a man who comes back from the dead.
SCP-2416-11 attempted to climb the side of the Chrysler building without proper equipment. Reports of death confirmed anomalous properties. Dr. H. orders the capture of SCP-2416. SCP-2416-12 cocaine overdose.
Believed it would alleviate sinus congestion.
SCP-2416-13 alcohol poisoning.
Believed it would lubricate a broken arm.
SCP-2416-14 exsanguinated after shoving a foot into a blender.
Circumstances unknown.
SCP-2416-15 shot by Site 59 security personnel for accessing a Sturm class info hazard.
This iteration was the first to come under Foundation custody.
SCP-2416-16 choked on food rations at Site 59.
Really liked oatmeal.
SCP-2416-17 head fracture from slamming own head on wall of its cell.
Was attempting to swat a fly.
SCP-2416-18 climbed into Site 59 incinerator.
Was looking for a bathroom.
SCP-2416-19 gained access to a lethal cognito hazard.
Was just curious.
SCP-2416-20 overdose of acetaminophen at Site 59.
See below.
Interviewed, SCP-2416-20.
Interviewer, Dr. Akinos. Begin log.
Please state your name for the record, SCP-2416-20.
Joe Grunderson Pike. I got a quick question before we get started.
Yes.
Joe, what did you say was the normal amount of those pills you gave me to take for a headache?
2 tablets.
Joe, wow. Yeah, that actually makes a lot more sense.
SCP-2416-20, having consumed 203 tablets of extra strength Tylenol from the breach desk storage bin, falls unconscious.
Medic.
End log.
Closing statement, SCP-2416-20 died shortly thereafter. SCP-2416-21 was later found wandering the streets of San Francisco and apprehended.
Thank you for tuning in. We hope that you enjoyed this broadcast. If you did, please subscribe, like and share it around. If you have any particular case files you'd like us to cover in future broadcasts, leave a comment below and we'll get around to it shortly. Tune in again tomorrow for more revelations.